Hi, my name is Julian Thompson, and I'm in Wellington, which is New Zealand's capital city. Wellington is renowned for its wild, windy weather, but also there are several active geological fault lines in the area which cause earthquakes. One of these fault lines goes right through the city itself, which is a major hazard. I'm going to be asking some geoscientists from GNS Science to tell me what they know. We're going to go around the area into several places to take a close-up look at the fault line itself.
The reason why we have earthquakes and faults in Wellington is because we are riding a plate boundary. The two plates are effectively in collision, and that collision is giving rise to the land as we know it. New Zealand is literally being pushed up.
The Wellington Fault runs right through this part of the world, and it is just one of a large number of faults that more or less form a zone running right through the eastern side of the North Island.
Well, here we are on top of Mount Victoria, central Wellington, and we're going to look at the Wellington Fault. Starting off at the very southern end, it runs out into Cook Strait behind this large hill with the microwave station on top, through the built-up area of Wellington, out into the harbour, and it runs right along the edge and then up the Hutt Valley. Oh, this is a great spot. This is a scenic spot on the Wellington coast of Cook Strait. This is Red Rocks Point. Just to the southwest, we've got Sinclair Head. And further to the southwest, you can see the South Island with the Kaikoura Ranges. This is a fabulous place to see the basement grey wacky rocks that the Wellington Fault cuts through. The most striking thing here is how it's all vertical. And what we're looking at are the old layers that accumulated horizontally on the sea floor, and they're now in the vertical. So the rocks have literally been pushed, squashed together, concertinaed, and resulting in a huge amount of shortening of the Earth's crust, effectively.
What we've got here is the main transportation hub for Wellington. We've got the main trunk railway here, which services all of the North Island, as well as the domestic trains for Wellington. We've got State Highway 1, and then on the other side of that we've got the ferry terminal as well as the port. So this is the real main hub of transportation for Wellington. Now, not only have we got all this hub here, but down coming in a line underneath that building, passing under the railway, under the road bridge and through that silo out into the harbour is the Wellington Fault.
Well, here we're on the main Hutt Road coming through to Lower Hutt, and we're standing on the intersection of Timoma Road and the Hutt Road. And if you look over here, we're seeing the roofs of the houses at the same level almost as the street. This means that this land where we're standing has lifted up relative to the other side a few metres over here, and all these houses are built on the one side of the fault line and we're standing on the other.
The Wellington Fault actually goes straight through here along the line of these trees, straight down the middle of this median strip. And you'll see that the houses have been set back, and this was done on purpose because they knew where the fault was, they mapped it and said, okay, we'll put the houses on either side.
Hey, we're at the California Park here. The Wellington Fault is really well expressed in this park. Let's go for a walk and I'll show you what it has to say. This ground surface that we're on used to be an old riverbed of the Hutt River. The Wellington Fault's moved, it's gone up and sideways. And that's this bump that we see, and that's how they knew where the fault was to locate the house, or keep the houses away at California Drive. We're on the south bank of the Hutt River here. And the Hutt River at this place is crossing the fault at almost right angles. And as it's eroded away the north bank, it's exposed the Wellington Fault, which is right at the far end, the downstream end of that bluff where the brown gravels meet the blue gravels. Okay. And this is the best exposure of the fault. Last earthquake happened about 300, 400 years ago. When will it happen next? Well, we do a whole bunch of earthquake research geared at two points. One, perhaps to figure out when it'll happen next, but more importantly, to get the infrastructure and the community resilient for when it does happen. It takes generations for a community to build resilience. So even if you could predict an earthquake, it doesn't protect the infrastructure. It's a probability thing, and the probability of it moving in the next 50 years is about 10%.
Well, that's been quite a journey. It's been perhaps a bit more than I expected. I've lived in Wellington for a number of years, and I've not seen all of those views and learnt all of those things that I just found out on this wonderful tour. It's also made me quite thoughtful about the reality of having an active fault line going through our hometown. I hope you've enjoyed the experience, and I hope you've learned a lot. And if you want to find out more or do some trips of your own, go to our website, and there's lots of information there all about the Wellington Fault.